Trade or invest? Hi, my name is Alex. Each time I see those market graphs going up and down, I'm telling myself, if I could only buy low, sell high, I would be a happy millionaire. I mean, it's easy. You only need to press that buy button and press that sell button, right? I did trade for a year for myself to understand how it works and how it feels. But then I realized that it takes considerable amount of my time, and in the end, what I earn per hour, it's not that great. So I started thinking to myself, what if I could find few great companies that I can invest in and just do nothing there, just waiting. And my life would be much better. I could probably earn less money, but in the end, my life would be much more balanced. And my earnings per hour will be much higher. And in the end, I could probably earn more than by trading without spending a lot of time trading. So if you are asking yourself those questions as well, and you are trying to decide to trade or to invest, then this video is for you. Even if you already know what trading is and investing is, there is that one little thing you do not know that you will find in this video. So keep watching. Let's start right now. At first glance, trading and investing might seem to be synonyms. The main goal of both is profitable trading. Buy low, sell high, a no-brainer, right? But although making money in the financial markets is the final goal of both investors and traders, their methods are totally different though. What they are and how they do it. As usual, you know, the devil is in detail. So, let's see what are the difference between trading and investing and which one suits you best. The final goal is to make big money.
Ooh.
To begin with, let's first determine the difference between trading and investing so the following makes more sense to you. Or if you already know what trading and investing difference are, you can skip this next chapter. So, traders hold stocks for the short-term high performance. In other words, they sell when price goes up sufficiently. While investors invest their money for years or decades or even longer. In this video, I will show you that investing and trading are two different approaches, and mixing up those can cause, you know, confusion to yourself, but as well, not the best results for your finances. What is more interesting is that you need to smash that like button. So as I've just mentioned, trading is to buy and sell on a short period of time, while investing is an approach that works on the buy and hold principle. So you understand that short-term market fluctuations are insignificant at the long term. That's why you don't care about what's happening today or tomorrow. What you care really is to see today what's the price and what the price will be in year two, three from now. That's the only thing you need to see. You don't need to check your price each day, each hour, so you can, you know, live tranquille. Remember, trader, short, investor, long. That's the biggest difference. So what traders do? Traders look usually at the prices during the day, and if a price goes up sufficiently, depending on what your goals are as a trader, you can, you know, earn like 0.5% or 1% or 2%, unless it's enough for you and depending on your strategy again. So anyway, you sell at that point. Simply put, trading is a skill of timing the market. Time is really important here. You need to follow news. You need to understand the best moment or approximately the best moment to buy. And for this, you're using different tools, more likely something like technical analysis. Technical analysis, if you don't know what that is simply a way to figure out, looking at the chart only, what is going to happen in the next even minutes or hours. Or you can look at the big chart and taking all this into account, applying Fibonacci. If you don't know what Fibonacci is, Google for this. So by applying some ways of looking at the graph and analyzing the graph, you can even skip news, everything. And just by looking at the graph, theoretically, you can see, is it a good time to buy or is it is it a good time to sell? This technical analysis tool is really helpful for day traders or the swing traders that exist as well. Basically, the difference is that day trader is making a lot of transactions during the day. Swing trader, he usually waits several days or probably weeks. And at some point he thinks, again, probably following technical analysis or just the price went up significantly, so it's enough for a trader to sell. So he sells at this point, and once he sold at this price, what's happening is he knows already that where he will put those money in. There's another stock on his watch list that just a really good, nice spot right now to buy. So this trader sells a position in one stock to enter in the position into another stock. That's what swing trading is. We can say that this is a part of trading as well because it's a short term. The level of risk is different too. Trading day by day, your risk is probably taken under control, it seems like, right? Because if you invest for multiple years, a lot of things can happen. And basically the time involves greater risk, because if you don't look what's happening over time with your stock, if you're checking only once a month or once a year, chances are high that you can miss that honey spot when you would need to sell. But again, we will jump to this later. In my opinion, trading involves a greater risk because the fluctuation is higher, and if you need to live off trading, you need to earn money almost every single day, or probably each 2 or 3 days, but you need to do some consistent income each month, right? Because this is trading. I mean, this is not something that you can do like 5 minutes per day. No, it actually needs you to spend some time. Now, if you like to trade, hit like. If you like to invest, hit like as well. But do not hit like twice, because that doesn't count. And also, trading could be different. If you look in the financial markets, like stock market. Stock market is only open 5 days a week from 9:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. If you're trading crypto, crypto is open 24 hours, 24/7. So imagine how would you sleep? I do remember those things when you buy something, those days when I tried to trade crypto, and it was in December 2017. Yeah, that was that crazy time when, you know, in one day you could see a token, a crypto asset just went up 2, 5, 10 times. It was crazy time. But in the same time, it could lose 20% to half of the value, even to 90% of the value if it was a scam, for example, in just a day or two. You're much more stressed when you're trying to do this with this kind of assets. But again, for stock market, it's a different story. Let's say that crypto, I mean, it's a stock market on steroids. So trading is much more risky, but in the same time, because of the fluctuation, you have more risk, but you have more potential reward. If you train yourself in some way, I'm not able to do this. I know there are other guys who live off of day trading. It's another lifestyle. So I would say you need to choose your lifestyle first and then to see what investing style suits you, because we have only one life. Investing might seem to return lower gains, but it has another magical thing. If you keep it for a long time, you get this compound interest that just keep stacking on. And if your stock is really good and if it paid dividends as well, that's, and it grows in value, that's when you're making an interesting gains. I know people who are day traders, and they said that they have friends who just invested at some point in some company or some asset and didn't bother to look at it for a year or two, and in the end of the year those people made more money than this particular day trader. And this day trader is not a novice, is not a beginner, he was about 10 to 15 years in this game already. So daily and weekly fluctuations do not affect you when, you know, when you do investing. Those short-term cycles are not really of concern to you. One more thing I wish you to understand, that in both cases you have different kind of money. I mean, you still have $100 here and $100 here when you trade or when you invest, but those are not the same money. So when the stock exchange year ends, and for example, we had growth of 6% for this year. And taking into account all those fluctuations, our $100 just, you know, ride the waves. And in the end, well, we have this 6%. That is why those money are called slow money. By contrast, traders enter and exit on each day of trade. That's why they're doing hundreds of transactions during the year, even more. And this should be a nightmare to calculate your taxes after that. So in this case, those $100 are used each time, and each time we use them to enter and exit market. That's why those money are called fast money. In other words, those money works harder. So here are some pros and cons for each of the methods. So the pros is that you need much smaller capital because you can reuse it over time. So what are the cons in day trading or in trading? First, you have competition. You are not alone there. The first who heard news and jumped in is the one who will earn more money, usually. But there are not only people there, there are also bots there. And bots is not something new. They exist for probably 5 or even more years now. The bots are simply a code that was written when doing some technical analysis automatically. Not even a human, you don't need to see this. Bots are trained with machine learning to understand when is the good time to buy. And these bots can buy instantly with millions of dollars. And so that is why you see in different markets prices went up and down almost instantaneously. Because those are not humans, those are robots. Robots, code robots. And the last con that I have for trading is that your taxes are much higher. Yes, it's good to have higher taxes because you earn more. But in this case, in this particular case, you pay taxes from the same tax bracket that you're in. So the pro for investing is that the taxes are lower because you pay usually what's called capital gains, and they, depending on the country, they can be up to 50% less than you would pay when you're doing day trading. And combined with time that you spend usually less time, it means you earn more per hour if you're invested in a great company and great opportunity, right? But the cons for investment is that you have to have a big capital to have a really nice investment, unless you invest in the company that just exploded. I think the bigger problem with investing is that you see your gains on the paper, but you never sell this. I mean, you wait for a year, 2, 3, 4, 5, and when you decide to sell, well, you have to wait. Whether with day trading, you see instantly what are your gains are and what are your losses. One more thing in favor of trading, that investment is hardly ever be a source of monthly income. Unless you invest in companies that pay dividends, and you have a lot of those companies, you receive those dividends quite often. But other than that, well, investment is usually long-term, as you know already, right? What are your experience with trading and investing? Just write me in the comments down below. I'm pretty sure you have a lot of things to share with others as well. Now, if you like to trade, hit like. If you like to invest, hit like as well. But do not hit like twice, because that doesn't count. If you're interested, I have some more stories about my personal trading and investing experience that I will put in the videos. So don't forget to subscribe to see those. Let's recap. You can do trading when you have this. You have a big volume, so you can sell easily or to buy, right? No, it's usually you need to sell, right? So second, you use technical analysis. You need to know how it works. Then you have also some different algorithmic approaches. You need to also recognize patterns in when you do technical analysis as well. And also the last technique is scalping technique. What is scalping? Scalping technique. It's when you not even day trade, but you kind of, you bought here, sell here, you know what's your cost per transaction are. If you make a small profit, you're doing it, but you're doing 5, 10, probably even more times a day. And that technique was really popular with crypto, because there you could see, you know, you could earn 1 to 5, even to 10% with scalping, which is, you could not do this with stock market. But that's not the story. You could lose 10% as well in 5 minutes. In general, if you're pretty attentive, if you spend time, if you know your fundamentals, should work. But again, I prefer to earn my main income today by some different things, not doing day trading or scalping. Investing. Investing is all about fundamental market analysis, diversification, classical financial principles, and the principle known as buy and hold. And usually when you do an investment like this, you probably invest in the business that you understand specifics of. For example, myself, being a developer, I can understand of how IT business works. And that's where it's interesting for me to invest as well. Or if you simply don't want to waste your time, just invest in ETF. Yeah, check out my video here about ETF. If you don't know what that is, that's pretty interesting possibility as well that stock market offers. What is more interesting is that you need to smash that like button. I do believe that all my free money should be invested, because that's the way how they can grow, because otherwise what money is? Money by default is inflationary. This means money loses value over time. So you have to invest them somewhere too, so you get this interest, or you just earn more money with the money you have. Otherwise, it's just sitting in your account, well, it's just disappearing, but you didn't notice it because the number still the same. But what's changed is the price. Usually traders are skilled technical people who understand how trends work, they understand market psychology, and they try to take maximum of profits out of these fluctuations. As for investors, it's a bit different. Well, it's good that you have the knowledge of how market psychology works in general, right? But that's not what you're looking at specifically. You're looking at fundamentals of any company, whether it's interesting to buy or not. That's why, for example, usually those IT companies are trading with really high P/E ratio because, well, a lot of people expect future gains. One important thing that Peter Thiel, one of the founder of PayPal, said one day is that, and I think it was in his book One, by the way, I highly recommend From Zero to One, brilliant book. It takes time for a company, even a great company, to get from the point where we have the technology, even though this technology can work, but still need time for people to use it, right? And it doesn't happen overnight. That is why we need to wait. This wait time can be up to 10 years. But so you understand, PayPal, for example, in 2000, when everything was booming in IT industry, PayPal had this high P/E ratio. But finally, if you're investing PayPal at that time, you won't be disappointed today, as you understand. So as for the investors, they understand how businesses are run and managed. What is important when you invest in a company, even though there might be some fluctuation due to a crisis or some other event. But finally, if all things are fine, this should explode in some time from now. But it takes years. But in the same time, imagine you invested $100 in a company and you see 10 to 100 increase in value. To have this 100 increase in value, even over 10 years, it's really hard to do with day trading. And especially when you invest in something, again, you spend much less time. Once you have the knowledge and you understand how business works and how those businesses are managed and what should it be look like, and so you get this information. Yes, you should check this information periodically though, because, you know, management's changing, business is changing itself. But it also depends whether you invest in a well-established business, which usually will not guarantee you high returns, or you invest in startup that proved its technology works. So for traders, if you miss the right time to sell, you can trade for a loss in the day because you need to close before the end of the day. Because during the non-trading time, things could change and you don't want to take that risk because you're taking this particular stock not because of its value over long term, but because of different external things that can impact price. So you don't want to be in this particular stock for too long. And investors, they keep themselves away from trends. They only do investing in value. So they patiently wait until the stock reaches the high which corresponds to their financial goals. At the end of the day, the ones who achieve their financial goal can be called successful. And that's what's the most important, right? If you set your goal, you want to achieve this by trading or investing, and that suits your lifestyle, go ahead. So you have to decide yourself. But that's not all. If you choose one or the other, if you choose to invest or to trade, never mind. But what is important is to stick to it and try to develop the skills, because skills come over time. But that time will pay you off, and with great interests, literally. I personally think that investing with trading, I choose investing for myself. But in the same time, investing can be totally different as well. You invest for long terms, yes, but the types of investing are different as well. And please subscribe to see my future videos, what the difference are. And I will set up a really interesting experiment where you can earn more by applying one or the other types of investment. So keep you posted, but don't forget to subscribe. I hope that volatility that you can experience in your life will only bring you higher profits. And that's it. See you. Bye.